Good morning, my Facebook Live friends. I am ready to do this again, and it means that much to me that this takes place today. So here we go. I'm hoping not to interrupt too much on my wall, but I am just have invited my friend Marcy to join me, and I am excited and believing that it's going to happen. Back here, and I just have to get back to my main screen here real quick, and because I can see that you see me, but see, I'm sorry, my hand's in the way there. So get back. Here we go. Woo! Okay, hi Annabelle, Carly, and oh, it's so good to see you all. So hang tight, and I'm going to be having a friend join me just in the next couple minutes, and I'm going to add her right now, Marcy. Preble is sitting with and talking with, and yesterday you saw, all of you that saw my live and said, how do you jump over obstacles? And
I did it!
There's beautiful Marcy. Oh, we did it!
High five! I have to show Neil, my computer expert. You know, when you don't know how to do it yourself, find somebody that knows how to do it.
And you know what, Marcy? Yesterday when we came on our live and you were persistent and we persisted and we persisted, And I spoke and said, you know, you were saying, you know what, it's just not meant to be today. And I said, that's okay, but it doesn't mean it's not meant to be forever. This is meant to be. Now, Marcy, you're going to find in a very short order that Marcy is just one of the most beautiful people that I have met in the last few weeks of my life. And we've been able to chat, and this woman has a story, and I really want to step out. I'm not going to step out of the picture because I'm going to interact with Marcy, but she has a story that you need to hear, and her story is so big that I really want you to hang in there and listen. The story is going to start with her son and why she heard about this beautiful synergizer that biohacks the body biohacks what's going on, because we have been hijacked, right?
Absolutely, right? We have.
We have been hijacked in our health. Yes. Our children are getting hijacked. So I want to hand this over to you. You have been blessed and you have been biohacked in your family and now in your own life by an NRF2 activator that is changing many lives and yours to start. So Marcy, I'm going to hand it over to you. Wow, I just bless you. Tell us your story. Talk about your son, and then let's talk about what's happened with you.
Sure, and I just want to thank you so much for having me on and bearing with me yesterday when we were having so much technology problems. So, yay, you know, you can really get through anything, and we are proving that today.
Yes, we are.
So, you know, I learned about Life Vantage about, gosh, has it been 6 years ago? And I was invited to watch that ABC investigative report. And in that report, I can still remember when they said after 30 days, you can't tell the difference in age between an 80-year-old and a 20-year-old. And I will tell you, back then, I was not feeling very young and I was not feeling very beautiful because, you know, I had special need kids. I had a little boy with autism at the time. He was in like seventh, eighth grade. And I had a little boy with seizure disorder, and life was tough. And so when I saw that primetime special, I was like, oh my gosh, to be 20 again, I really want that, you know? But then I was like, gosh, could it really be true? You know, that sounds too good to be true. So I actually came home from watching, and then I called my good friend. He's an orthopedic surgeon. We've just been friends for a long time, but he's a doctor, and he like is more of a natural doctor, but I knew he would know. So I called him up and I said, hey, Scott, take a look at this primetime special and tell me if it's real. So we did. And about 2 days later, he calls me back and he goes, Marcy, not only is this real, but you should be on it for yourself and all your kids. And I want to be on it I want it for my patients, and I want it for my wife who has some colon issues. And I said, why? And he goes, well, first of all, I've never seen a natural product in PubMed.gov, and that's the Institute of National Health, you know, Medicine. That's where all the research is for pharma, and this is a natural product. I mean, this research. specifically is why you should be on it. The first one is from American Heart Association Journal. And in that study, it said that it reduced, Protandim, reduced scarring of the heart by 50%. And it did so by four mechanisms. It increased your own body to make more antioxidant enzymes, more anti-inflammatory enzymes, more detoxification enzymes, and more anti-scarring enzymes. He says, if there's something that's turning on your own body to do that, that's incredible. And that's never, I've never seen that. He goes, and the other study is the 2008 study, and it says that by taking Protandim, your glutathione increases by like 300%. And he said, you know, Mars, glutathione, you know, you've always wanted to increase that for your child with autism, and you've never been able to. And I said, you know, you're right. You know, glutathione is the main, it's the immune system for our kids. It's the main, it's one of the antioxidant pathways, as well as one of the detoxification pathways. And in the world of autism, we've always believed that has been broken in our children. So he said, and you know what? If you can put out something called the free radicals, you know, a million per second every second, like a fire hose in every room of the house versus like a traditional antioxidant, which trust me is awesome. Who doesn't love fresh organic greens? I do. I juice all the time now, but that only takes the fire out one-to-one, like a Dixie cup. And I really wanted for myself and my children to put the fire out a whole lot. And so what happened is we all went on it. And we've been on it for like 6 years. And I'm happy to say my little boy who had seizure disorder, he's been off of Depakote for about 5 years now. And our last seizure scan came back that he was seizure free. It showed that he had seizures in the background, but he has them no longer. And so awesome. My autistic son now is 19. And if any of you guys saw him, I mean, he's now 6'3". And I'm telling you, he's hot. I mean, he could be a model, right? Like, I never thought my autistic son would have a girlfriend, much less be like walking down the street and all these girls look at him. Now, granted, a lot of times he doesn't really know what to do with that. But I'm like, God, there's another one looking at you. And so it's super, super cute. And he's really off. He's been off his antifungals, his antivirals. He's off his gluten casein-free diet, and he's off his clozapam, which he used for anxiety, and the one thing he's still on is Prozac. We'd like to reduce that, but the good news is Joe McCord said Protandim processes in a different system than pharmaceuticals. I think one processes in the liver and one processes in the kidney, but basically they don't mix, so it's safe. And so today, you know, he's doing great. And I will tell you that his favorite thing right now is working out, and he eats healthy food, salads and proteins, and he doesn't really eat very many carbs anymore. And like, I'm telling him, you've got to get me there. Like, my son is now my motivator, and I'm really, really super duper proud of him. So, you know, that's really what happened. And then, you know, my life took a dramatic turn about 6 months ago. I was just living my life, working my business, enjoying my friends, living freedom. And I was undressing, and I saw a big lump come out of my right breast, and I didn't see it coming. It was huge. And I'm like, oh my gosh. And here's a note for women. You know, get your mammograms once a year. I hadn't had a mammogram for 3 years. And I caught it early, it would have been no big deal. But I did not catch it early. I caught it really late. And so that's what happened to me. And when they did all the testing and checks, they said to me, well, it's definitely stage two, but we don't see it in the lymph system. And so that's good. And so I went for what is called a double mastectomy. And when they went into surgery, they did find it microscopically in my lymph system. And so it did move it to stage three. But the interesting part is my surgeon, after I got out of surgery, said, oh my God, you had more breast cancer in that right breast than I've ever seen. In fact, I think they were having a feast. It was like they were having an all you can eat buffet in your breast. It's kind of funny, but and he goes, but for that. He goes, I can't believe that it was barely in the lymph system. It was microscopic, so much that we didn't even think it was there. And I truly believe that taking one Protandim a day for the last 6 years saved my life. Like, it literally made it not spread. Like, it like contained it right there, because for how much I had, I should have been stage 4, which would have been all over my liver and all over my, in my bones. And you know what? It's not. And I am cancer free now. We've got it all. I'm clear. I've just done my, I chose, every woman makes their own decision, and I'm not telling what decision any woman should make. Some people go natural, some people do only Western. I chose to do a combination of natural and Western medicine. That was my choice. And so I did decide to do, for stage 3, I did 16 rounds of chemo, and that's a lot of chemo. And so my choice was to take Protandim as I did the chemo. There's a lot of controversy. In fact, my doctor actually would recommend me not doing that during chemo, because he didn't want Protandim to kill the chemo. But I kind of figured, because I talked to so many of my girlfriends who've been through this, that, you know, chemo is going to kill everything in my body, including me. And so I'm going to protect myself. And that was my decision. And I'm not telling anybody to do my decision. I'm just telling you what my decision was. And so I did 2 Protandim twice a day during chemo. And I'm happy to say I weathered okay. And look, I wear a penguin cold cap. So I still have, it's not great. But hey, it's still my hair. I still have hair. Oh. My friend Liz is going to color it for me this week and cut it a bit. So it might actually be hot again. But yay. Yeah. So that's any amazing woman that's going through this, you put this big cold cap on your head and you save your hair. And so that makes you feel a little more beautiful. Yes. And so what was I going to say? So now that chemo is over, I do take 2 Protandim in the morning and 2 at night. That's what I'm taking, because I just don't want it to come back. And I just want to live. And I'm in gratitude for being alive. And I guess the other thing I would say is that life is precious. And do what you want to do. Don't do what you think you have to do, because life is short. And just enjoy every single moment of it. You know, that's all I can really tell you. And take preventative health seriously. Take your Protandim, share the Protandim, because it does protect and it keeps stuff from coming. And I'm just really in gratitude that I've had it for all these years. And in about 6 months, I'll be that hot 20-year-old again, like in the 80 is the new 20. And you got to give me 6 months. Anyway.
Yeah.
Oh, and I was going to say this from a business perspective, you know, thank God I had Life Vantage and the residual income, because when this hit, I fell hard. And, you know, I still had a ton of bills to pay, and Life Vantage kept me afloat. I didn't have, you know, I had medical insurance, thank God, but I didn't have, you know, what is that called? Like when you have, you know, disability, you know, I had none of that kind of stuff, you know? So Life Vantage and that residual income kept me afloat during a really hard time. So, you know, Carrie Dickey always says, you know, dig the well before, what is it? Dig the well before it goes dry.
Before you need it
or before it goes dry.
Before you're thirsty.
Oh, that's it, thirsty. I knew there was, dig the well before you're thirsty. So that is a really true statement. So with that, I don't know if you have any questions for me, but I'm in LaTip today. I'm working again, which is really super fun. But they are kicking me out.
I'm going to ask our audience out there, because your story of you know, and people, when they make the choice to walk from, in, you know, back into health, and there's going to be a lot of people that are like, I just got diagnosed with a cancer of any way. And there's so many different kinds of cancers, and we're not saying that this NRF2 synergizer is going to treat, cure, mitigate, or anything. But Marcy, talk about again what it did in your body while you were parallel. You were walking through how many rounds of chemotherapy?
16.
So you went through 16 rounds of chemotherapy, but And we know that people that have been through chemotherapy, some people never come out of it when they have that many rounds. People that are watching right now, that is her hair. How did that happen? That she kept her hair through 16 rounds of chemotherapy, but during that, she did say, the doctor said, get off of this little yellow pill. Don't take it because we're afraid. And imagine that the doctors are so afraid that this little yellow pill is strong enough to stop the activation of chemotherapy from killing the cancer. But you're saying, no, we're not going to stop the chemo, but I'm not going to stop this because I have happy cells still in my body. Talk about why you chose to do both, even against the doctor's orders or recommendations. Let it be a lesson. The doctor can recommend, but you own your body.
Talk about that. You know, that is true. You know, I do own my own body, and it is, everybody has their own decision to make. But, you know, I can still remember doing three-way calls with Brenda Geary maybe 5 years ago when she was diagnosed with stage 3 breast cancer. And she, I remember her saying, it's a woman's choice. And she said, but, you know, she said basically that that the cancer is, the chemo's going to kill the cancer, but I don't want my organs to go. And I'll never forget that. And at the time when it didn't happen to me, I was, you know, going, well, that makes sense. That makes sense. But you know what? It's one thing to hear it. It's another thing to live it. And so I really, when I was living it, it came really, it was in my ear. And I remember when the doctor said what he said, I can still remember hearing Brenda. And I remember thinking to myself, I'm more like her. And I'm going to do it because she's on the other side and I can get to the other side too, you know? And I want to get to the other side with a good colon and a good liver and with my inflammation in check. And I want to get to the other side without neuropathy. And so many women that I love, you know, they have really bad neuropathy in their feet now from all the chemo. And I have been blessed where that, it's pretty much, I'm not getting that. You know, I'm so blessed that I have not had the side effects that, you know, that can happen from all of this. Now, we're just all doing our best, and every woman has to make their own decision for their own body. And I guess we'll know in a few years if my decision was correct. I'll let you know. I'll keep you posted.
I believe it will be, Marcy. And this has just been a story that I just see the hearts flying across the stage. And if you know someone on this that has autism in their family, an autistic child, or if you know someone who has been diagnosed suffering post-pre, what would you say in closing to anybody that maybe is post, that once has had it, they beat it, but going forward, what is going to be your journey with this health, with this NRF2 synergizer, with continuing to biohack your body and make sure your genes behave?
So,
what would you say? What's going to be your going forward?
So absolutely, you know, during chemo, you have to make your own decision and you have to listen to your doctor. And I'm not saying right or wrong on that. I'm just saying you do what's best. But after chemo, oh my gosh, like you're crazy not to do Protandim, because Protandim is a NRF2 activator and it talks to the genes and it turns back on your antioxidant genes, your detoxification genes, your anti-scarring genes, and your anti-inflammatory genes. Like who wouldn't want to do that so cancer doesn't come back? And I will tell you that, you know, Joe McCord back in the day, if any of you guys remember when he spoke at convention, he said, you know, basically, I don't know if you can see my finger. Well, I'll just say it. He goes, you know, you have normal cells and then you get oxidative stress, which, you know, oxidative stress is mutations that turn good cells into bad. And oxidative stress comes from the water we drink. Gosh, we're on our cell phones all the time, the radiation, the food, GMO foods, I mean, the gas, the toxins. We're living in a very toxic environment right now, okay? And so those free radicals are causing oxidative stress. So your normal cells get these free radical causing oxidative stress. They get stressed out, and those stressed out cells turn into cancer, okay? So what I did with chemo kills fast-growing cells, all of them. That's why most people lose their hair. Hair is a fast-growing cell. That's why on the good note, I have the most softest skin ever. I have, some people say, look at your skin. And they go, oh my God, your skin is beautiful. And I'm like, yeah, that's chemo skin. Because skin is a very fast growing cell. So it kills it really fast. So chemo kills fast growing cells. So you kill fast growing cells with chemo. What Protandim does is it takes it goes from the cancer cells to the stress cells back to normal. And so you're keeping your normal cells normal, or if your cells have turned into stressed, it takes it back down to normal. And so for me, because I've had all of this, you know, I've already killed all the cancer. It's out of my body. I'm cancer free now. So I want to keep those stress cells normal, and I want to keep my, you know, I want to take those to normal, and I want to keep my normal cells normal. Like, it's not fun to have this happen. Like, you just want to keep it not to come back. And the best way not to have it to come back is to keep your cells not stressed out anymore. So no more stress, ladies.
Right?
Yeah.
Powerful. Absolutely powerful. So for those of you that know Marcy, and if you have not been introduced to this product, I'm going to say you better be messaging her today. For those of you that know me that have not already been on this, you had better be messaging me today. For those of you that this has been shared to you by someone who loves you so much that they are sharing this video with you today, you would be better messaging them and asking them what this is all about. And they're going to send you a biohacking your body video that's going to blow your mind. Everyone needs to know about this. Am I not right, Marcy? Everybody.
Absolutely. You know, protect
Marcy,
yourself.
I love you for sharing. I love you for spending this time with me. That your very first live split screen video. I'm so proud of you for persisting. We stepped over a lot of obstacles, people, to get this message to you. So you've got to know that this message was meant for you to listen to. Because we worked hard to get this online right now.
Yeah, yes, we did.
Yes, we did. So, Marcy, I cannot wait to meet you in person and hug your neck, jump up and down, and celebrate with you. I love you. You're a beautiful human being. I love that you have a long life ahead. You are going to see lots and lots of grandchildren get married. Mwah. I love you. Bless you, and we'll talk again very soon.
Yeah, thank you, Becky, and thank you so much for teaching me technology and making it happen. And if it was a little bit rocky, we just did it because this was when we could do it. And so it is what it is today. And gratitude for all of you, and love you much. Have a great day. Bye now.
Bye.